Hey everyone, in this video I want to go over an example of how to do k-means clustering. This video is mostly going to be an example of applying the algorithm using Python code, so I'm going to switch over to Python soon, but before I show the application, I first wanted to go over some of the basics of how k-means clustering works. So with k-means clustering, k is equal to the number of clusters, and this is a value that you have to provide the algorithm. It will cluster as many clusters as you provide, and you have to know beforehand how many clusters you want from your data. There are methods of finding the optimal number of clusters that are a bit subjective but can be useful. So for example, there's something called the elbow method, and there are gap statistics as well to help you determine the number of clusters or optimal number of clusters based on a certain statistic. But k will be a value that you manually put into your algorithm. Once you have your desired k that you know you want from your data, let's say k is equal to 2 for this example, the way the algorithm works is you're going to iterate over an initial random seed. The number of random seeds you have is going to be equal to k. Using this data as an example, we're going to start with 2 random seeds, and let me put the random seed here and the second random seed here. The way the k-means clustering algorithm works is that from this initial seed, your data is going to be clustered according to the nearest Euclidean distance. So it's going to calculate the Euclidean distance, let's say for this point. The Euclidean distance will be calculated from the first seed that's blue and the second seed that's green, and it's going to be clustered according to which distance is minimized. So this data point here is going to be clustered as part of the blue cluster because it's closer to the random seed in blue. And then that's going to create an initial clustering for the first iteration based on the random seeds. Just visually, I'm going to say that all of these points here that are closer to blue would get clustered as blue, and all of these points that are closer to the green random seed would get clustered as green. After this first iteration is completed, these random seeds will no longer be used, and a new centroid is going to be calculated based on the first pass of the newly classified data. Based on all these blue points in the next iteration, the centroid is probably for blue somewhere around here, and for green, the new centroid is probably somewhere around here. And then in this next iteration, the same thing would be done for all the data points. So again, for this data point, the Euclidean distance would be calculated for the centroid that's blue and the centroid that's green. And across many iterations, you're eventually going to get to a point where all the data points are clustered, and even adding different centroids won't move or change any of the clustered values. By doing this over a couple iterations, you're going to slowly move the centroid to the true center for each cluster, and you'll get the optimal clustering in that way. So that's a brief overview of how k-means clustering works. The k-means clustering algorithm is usually one that we would not be expected to do by hand, so it's much more likely and more often we're going to pass the algorithm or use the algorithm through a computer and have the computer output the clusters for us. So for this video, I'm going to use a Python code and Python demo for k-means clustering, and I'll put all of this code and the sample dataset in the description box below. So at the top of the code, I'm going to import all the libraries that we're going to use for this demo. So we have pandas for data frames, numpy, pyplot for plotting, and we're going to use the k-means clustering algorithm from scikit-learn, and seaborn is another plotting package. So I'm going to run this first line of code that just imports all the libraries and modules and functions that we're going to use for this demo. In the next step, I'm going to actually load the raw data. The example that I'm going to use is data for every country around the world, and each observation is a country, and the data is one column is longitude and one column is latitude. So this is giving a dot for every country, and the dot is equal to the centroid. So I have the centroid for Angola, the United States, every country around the world. And I have that in a CSV file called countries.csv. So I'm going to load that in using pandas. And if you want to see what the raw data looks like, I'm going to plot the data. So in this next line of code, I'm going to use pyplot to create a scatter plot. The x values will be longitude, the y values will be latitude, and it's going to plot every observation in a plot. So this is the data that we're working with. But you can kind of see here, I can make out the outline of all the different centroids for all the countries in Africa. Here is a cluster of many different observations for Europe. Europe has a bunch of small countries. Over here, we have North America that has a few big countries and their centroids. And so you can kind of already see, just looking at this, it kind of already resembles a world map or world projection. So we're going to play around with clustering these observations. So in the next part of the code, I'm just going to create a dataset that has only the columns with the data that we're going to cluster. So we want to cluster the two columns, longitude and latitude. So I'm just going to remove the column that has all the country names because we're not going to use that information in the actual k-means clustering algorithm. So I created a copy of the original dataset and I called it data2. And then in this line of code, I'm just selecting the first two columns to include only the columns longitude and latitude. And then I'm going to print a preview of what the data looks like. So data two has just two columns now, and the first column is longitude and the second column is latitude. And then in the next part of the code, using this data to dataset, we're going to actually apply the k-means clustering algorithm. Like I said in the beginning of the video, we can cluster this using any number of clusters as long as it's less than or equal to the number of observations that we have in the dataset. So we could cluster this dataset as many as 240 times. I'm not going to do in this video an optimal number of clusters. I'm just going to show a couple different examples. Let's start by passing in k is equal to 2. So let's say using this data set, we want two separate clusters and see what the algorithm produces for us. We're going to write k means is equal to uppercase K, uppercase M means, and then we're going to pass in K, which is the number of clusters that we want. In this first example, I'm going to pass in 2, so it gives me 2 clusters. So that's going to create an algorithm that's going to find 2 clusters, and then I'm going to use it to predict clusters for the dataset data2. By doing that, I'm going to use this line of code, identified underscore clusters equals k-means dot fit predict, and then we're passing in the dataset. This identified clusters is going to be a column with 2 values for the 2 different clusters. So every observation is going to be either clustered in value 1 or 2. So we're going to run that line of code. I'm going to append that final column that we created to our data2 dataset. So then we'll have the longitude, latitude, and the cluster values in a new dataset. I'm going to do that in these lines of codes. So data with clusters, I'm going to copy data2 dataset in this line. And then in the second lines and third lines, I'm going to add a new column called clusters and pass in the values identified clusters. And then this line of code will just print the dataset. So the two possible values for clusters are 1 and 0. Every observation now has a longitude value, a latitude value, and a cluster value. In this next line of code, I'm going to plot the data with the clusters in it. So I'm going to use pyplot. I'm going to create a scatter plot where again, the x-axis is longitude, the y-axis is latitude. And then we're going to color using C is equal to and pass in the third column with the clusters information. And we're going to use the rainbow color palette. So when I run this line of code, that produces this map. So this map with two clusters shows that the k-means algorithm basically divided the countries into a Western hemisphere where you see you have basically North America and South America and maybe some countries that are sort of in the Pacific, maybe some islands in the Pacific as one cluster and then all the Eastern hemisphere countries as a second cluster. So you see Europe, Asia, Africa are all kind of clustered into the second cluster. So this is one possible way of clustering the data and that kind of makes sense that there's a large separation. There's basically a whole ocean here and a whole ocean here that would separate the data very logically. Another possible example would be instead of clustering into 2, we could do k means is equal to 7 or k is equal to 7 because there are 7 continents. So if we do that, we might expect that the map would look similar to what a continental map of the world would look like. So I'm going to rerun my code and just change k from 2 to 7 to see what that result will look like. And then when I plot that data set, this is what the k-means algorithm came up with. So it does actually look a bit different than what the continental separations are. So here it's still separating the Americas and it's kind of grouping them as one. Here it kind of looks like sub-Saharan Africa got grouped together, but also got grouped together with Antarctica. This seems to be Western Europe, maybe some Asian countries over here. So it looks in some ways similar to a continental map, but a little bit different. I'm going to also try 3 to see what 3 will give me. So this would be the result for k is equal to 3. It's grouping a lot the values according to their latitudes. So it has a tendency to group the Americas together, has a tendency to group Europe and Africa together, which makes sense based on how the centroids are lining up. And this is what k is equal to 4 would look like. So I could keep playing around with this, but that is pretty much the demo that I wanted to show in this video. So I'll end the video here, and thank you guys for watching.